would have been.
Thank you.
love very much, each in our own special way. He was a very caring man and a physician who has deeply touched so very many people, as we have learned over the past couple of weeks, talking with family and friends. My father and I have lived apart since I was a boy. Since I was the oldest, I talked to Dad a lot about my brothers and sisters and the military. I remember as a boy, Dad taking my brother Eric and I fishing and camping. He loved fishing. He taught us how to land navigate and how to use a compass. I could tell that our navigation skills were improving slowly when Dad issued us whistles in case we got lost. Dad taught us how to swim, the importance of trust, values, and education. He taught us how to be young men and then gentlemen. He was always a fabulous role model. When I entered active duty, he taught me how to be an aggressive, confident, and professional Army officer. I respect and admire my father. Like no other human being. Through the years, we talked a lot about Eric and his intellectual ability and how could we motivate him to utilize his potential and how he loved him. We talked about Joel and what an exceptional, talented skater he is and that we wanted him to make it to the Olympics someday, and he will, and how much he loved him. We talked about Edie and all that she overcame to achieve an RA commission and what an outstanding Army nurse she is and will become, and how much he loved her. We talked about Sarah and how incredibly talented she was as an athlete and a student. He was always excited to replay to me many of Sarah's heroics on the basketball court and in track and field. He had all the events memorized in detail. The memories made him very happy. And he loved her very much. Dad also had a twinkle in his eye for my wife, Lori Ann, and his grandchildren, Megan, Sarah, and Katie Rose. He spoke of them highly and loved them dearly. We will all miss Dad in our own personal ways. But our memories and love for him will never dim. I want to say to our family today that we must carry on in Dad's life. He will always be with us. We must stick together and let nothing interfere with our love and concern for each other. Dad would want it to be that way forever. He was a soldier, a physician, and a drummer, didn't he, Randall?
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. And from the Psalter, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And from 2 Timothy, for I am already on the point of being sacrificed. The time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Henceforth there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all those who have loved his care. Here ends our readings. in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother, Joseph Wendell McKeever. And we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace. Amen. Please join me in the praying of our Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Will you please stand for military honors?